The much-vaunted F-16 has failed its first test in the Ukrainian theater of conflict. Kyiv's military said an F-16 fighter jet used by Ukraine crashed on Monday. It is the first such loss reported since the long-awaited arrival of the U.S.-made planes in the country that was confirmed this month. In a statement on Facebook, the Ukrainian general staff said that the jet came down and its pilot died while it was approaching a target during a Russian airstrike. It added that the F-16s had demonstrated high efficiency and downed four Russian cruise missiles. The statement further said connection with one of the aircraft was lost while it was approaching the next target. As it turned out later, the plane crashed, the pilot died. The crash is now being investigated, and international experts will be invited to take part in the probe. Pentagon spokesperson Sabrina Singh said that the Department of Defense has no knowledge of Ukraine seeking assistance after the crash. Singh did not reveal how many American F-16s are currently in Ukraine, but she expressed pride in the U.S. training of some of the Ukrainian pilots flying the jets, noting that they are defending their skies and their country.
Seen the reports, I'm not aware of any assistance or request for assistance from the Ukrainian side to us about this particular incident. But I'd refer you to the Ukrainians more to speak to any specifics on this pilot.
On Tuesday, Ukrainian President Zelensky said Russian missiles were shot down by Western-supplied F-16 fighter jets before they reached their targets. But the new revelation has put a question mark on Zelensky's claims. Zelensky has been asking for over 100 F-16s to counter the Russian air power. The deployment of the F-16s marks a crucial enhancement in Ukraine's air defense capabilities. Since Ukraine took delivery of its first batch of F-16 fighter jets, it was clear that these aircraft will play a crucial role in the nation's air defense strategy. But the reports of the crash shows how vulnerable the frontline jet is to enemy fire. Analysts have raised doubts that Ukrainian pilots have not been trained well enough to fly these machines. Now, Ukraine has argued that the $64 million fighter jets, missiles and targeting system will enable them to identify enemy ground radars and destroy them. The F-16 jets are one of the top jet fighters in the world. They are fast and extremely agile. The powerful engine can generate excellent thrust-to-weight ratio due to the overall lightness of it, propelling the F-16 to twice the speed of the sound at high altitude. Now, meanwhile, in eastern Ukraine, at least one person has died and six injured during Russian shelling of the region. The town is miles away from the front line, and it is one of the most affected cities in the region. According to Donetsk governor, it comes under enemy fire almost every day. Now, for more on this, we were earlier joined by Lieutenant Colonel Daniel Davis. He's a military expert and a host of Daniel Davis Deep Dive on YouTube. Take a listen to what he said.
You had Lindsey Graham in Kyiv a week or so ago openly campaigning to have Western NATO pilots who were F-16 trained to volunteer to fly these airframes, quote, until we get the Ukrainian pilots trained up. So he was admitting even then that they were not yet adequately trained in the numbers, even for the handful of airframes that they've had. And by the way, there are also some credible reports that at least two of the F-16s have been destroyed on the ground. So it's not clear at all how many are even still airworthy.